the community services?
That is correct, Chair, yes. Very much. I'll start with a brief statement, if I may. Over the past 18 months or so, the Council has been looking at a number of leisure services, principally because of some of the financial pressures that it finds itself in. We've heard about those pressures this evening. Obviously, this is a portfolio that is really has a value in terms of the amount of taxpayers' money that goes towards it. Take the whole of cultural services, around about £17 million. And golf is one part of that, not by any means the only part. Obviously, the desire amongst members was to look at ways of transforming these services, of potentially sustaining them, of making sure the services are still available to members of the public, to rural residents, and hopefully to improve them at the same time. And for that reason, members of this committee, prior to Christmas and shortly afterwards, had a report that was part and parcel of, as you've already heard, of the Council's overall financial package, which looked at the potentiality of going to the marketplace and saying and offering a long-term lease on two of the courses, which you've heard tonight. Within that followed, I suppose, some soft market testing where a number of options, an options analysis, which basically looked at a number of different ways of potentially either investing in courses, running them, continuing to run them in-house, or indeed going out to a concession contracting. The soft market testing told us ostensibly that the market itself was much more likely to respond to but clearly the detail around that needed to be negotiated, it needed to be worked out. And as a consequence, following a relatively positive exercise, we went before the cabinet member to ask her to give us permission as officers to negotiate. So nothing has been decided, it's just to negotiate at this stage. And that's where we are with this process at the moment. I would just add a couple more comments in relation to some things that have been said earlier. There has been some talk about the improvement, perceived improvement of the quality of the courses, particularly in our park and the ones. There has been a different way of working that has been implemented in the last 18 months, a much firmer contractor client role between leisure services staff and parks and countryside staff. Maintaining the quality of the course. And following the certain consultant reports, which have also been referred to today, there has been a much more rigorous attempt at trying to improve the quality of those courses. Not for any Machiavellian reason, but just simply because the future is very uncertain in terms of where this project is going. For a fact, I'm sort of sitting here today, so it says that. So obviously, there is a need to maintain the quality of the courses wherever practical. That doesn't obviously explain why there are differences in quality. Those differences in quality are due to, as previous speakers have said, past investment or the lack of past investment. And therefore, we're not dealing at the same type of level in terms of raising up standards for each of the specific courses. So it's a different way of working, and it's also been, we've introduced a different couple of posts, one overall grounds maintenance coordinator, which has much greater control over different teams working on the courses, and hopefully can respond to the needs much more of various different individuals and customers as they use those courses. There's been quite a bit of talk this afternoon or this evening about the level of usage of golfs. I can't comment on sporting figures because I'm unaware of those that Cllr Lewis raised earlier. What I would say is that overall Wirral is very well blessed for